it again.
Perfect. Now we get the holes lined out and drilled into this cone. So we got plenty of clearance, so that's awesome.
Cool.
Gotta see where it dug in a little bit. That's what I was talking about when I said I shouldn't have taken this down to dimension OD. I should have left a little bit there. And I could have turned it down, made it super pretty. But I'm not too worried about it. Okay. So we'll get that lined up. Doesn't really matter where I put them. So I would be using a 3/8 course. So is that like a 16 or 18 pitch or thread count? Something like that. 3/8 course. Yeah, when I get this all lined out, I'll be back. So I got her set up. We're gonna cut the cone shape on there now. Got it set, held on there kinda, not the best way, but the only way I could think of doing it without making more stuff to hold it. So that's that backing plate that's gripping it right now. Hopefully it don't fly out. I'm gonna be doing a 50 degree angle cut, and I'm going to leave about an inch wide flat spot or so, and then move the angle from there, because I don't need it to be a point. And to be able to miss the inner bore in there for the bearings, I'm going to have, I can't get real tight. I'd have to do like a 30 degree cut to make a point, but I don't need this to have a point. I just need it to be hold you know, bigger stuff. That's kind of the point of it. So we'll do a 50 degree angle cut, and then I would like to leave about half inch on the back side there, a flat spot or flat non-tapered cut. But, you know, if it's a little smaller than that, so be it. If it's a little bigger, that's okay too. Nothing super critical on this.